You can use actions in Copilot Studio so that your Copilot can actually do things on behalf of the user. This video is part of my Copilot Studio Essential series, where we cover all of the core skills in under 10 minutes. Actions come in many different shapes and sizes. Let's take a look at the options here in the actions menu of my Copilot. And the first time I come in to do this, I've got a lovely add an action button, and here are all the different choices that I've got. If you are someone who's worked with Power Platform before, you'll find a fairly familiar screen of things here. So you've actually got a whole lot of connectors. These are the Power Platform connectors. There are thousands of these pre-built connectors. Some of the most common ones we're seeing on the screen here will connect you to Excel, SharePoint, but there are connectors out to all sorts of different productivity and enterprise systems. If you've built your own custom connectors to other services, you can use those here as well. You can also use Power Automate flows. So if you've built a flow, then you can bring that in here where the Copilot is the trigger, getting a piece of information from the conversation to run that flow and to return information back into your Copilot conversation. You can also add skills if you're working with the bot framework, a much more advanced area, and add APIs for custom connectors. So lots of different choices in there. I'm going to use one here that if you're a beginner is very easy to follow along with because you don't need any coding skills and you don't even need to sign up for anything, which is the weather connector. This is also a really good one for you to just understand the concept of what these actions can actually do. So this one is giving us an option to start configuring this action. And first up, with any kind of connector, is what type of authentication is needed. So usually it will start with assuming that the user needs to authenticate in, they have to sign into the service. If you're using an enterprise system of any kind, that's certainly how you'd want it to behave. But in this case, I'm going to go with the author authentication, which means that I'm setting that up and my users won't need to do any authentication. This particular connector doesn't actually need authentication. And then we can scroll down here and have a look at the different configuration options. We've got the action name, the display name, and then the description. The description is really important in helping the Copilot understand when it's going to trigger this action. So this one already comes with a pretty good description that's in here. Let's click next to go to the next stage, and you'll see that we've now got inputs and outputs. The inputs is what the action is expecting to receive from the conversation. So it's going to expect a location, which is where do you want the weather to be, and then the units, whether we're using imperial or metric measurements. Now, what I can do here is come in and say, let's edit those inputs so we can see more about what's going on. How do we want to get the information about the location? This is coming from what the user is filling in. That makes sense, and it's accepting different types of ways of receiving that information. Very happy with that. The units, however, dynamically fill based on the user's response. What that would do is create an experience where it actually asks the user, which one do you want, which isn't typical. Mostly you would know who your users are and what they want to do. So instead of that, we're going to say, let's set that as a particular value. Confirm that I understand I'm changing that. And then I can choose the value here, I for imperial, C for Celsius or metric, which is how I work. So we're going to go with that one and click save. So now we've actually got with the inputs, it's going to look for the location from the user, but it's always set to return that in Celsius. Let's take a look at the outputs here. So this connector comes with a stack of outputs. We've got 39 different outputs in there. So let's come in and have a look at that. So we've got all of these different things. Now, if we don't want all of those, for instance, let's say I'm not interested in anything about the moon. So you can see I'm deleting all of these and the number of outputs is being reduced. So you can choose which ones you want to keep in there. That gives us enough to be going on with for now. And let's click save. So now we have set our inputs and our outputs. We'll go next. And then there's our final stage to review and finish. So we accept that, and it's going to put that connector ready for us to use. And that's all done and ready to go. So let's give it a test. What is the weather in Melbourne today? It should be able to identify the location, Melbourne, from my prompt. And look at that, comes back with all of that information. You can ask it more specific questions as well. So we can come in here and put something in about finding that one particular piece of information from all of those outputs, rather than it giving the whole the whole set of information. If you want more control over how that response comes back, you can click in here and edit that in the output section. You'll see here to choose how this will be displayed. So we want to say respond to the user. If we select that, this is now AI dynamically generates a message, which is the default, which it's what it is doing. But you can actually come in here and say you create a message, and you can put in the specific type of response that you want in there, including bringing in any particular variables. So this gives you access to all of those different things. So let's say you only ever wanted the response to come back with the top temperature, regardless of what the user asks, you can control for that there. You can also use actions to extend Microsoft 365 Copilot. So if you've got that license, which is the $30 per user per month license, you can use this to say, let's add actions in here so that that Copilot from Microsoft 365 can do more things. You've got those same connectors and flows in there and a few other things that you can do that are additional with that license. Once you've got your actions lined up inside your Copilot, you are ready to finalize your settings and publish out to the right channel. I'll see you in the next video for how to do that.